Hey guys,
welcome to the Way from Keyboard, and today we're taking a look at Is Command & Conquer Red Alert worth playing? Command & Conquer is an RTS game, that will say a real-time strategy game, released on the PlayStation 1 and also PC in 1996. Command & Conquer Red Alert played in an alternate universe in which the Second World War didn't happen, all because of a scientist who traveled back in time and killed Hitler. Because there weren't any Nazis to start the war,
Someone else did it.
Yeah, the Soviet Union started to build its empire, and the Soviet Union tried to take over the entire world. So basically that's the main premises of this game. In this game, at the start of the game, you can choose between two factions. You can go for the Soviet Union, or you could choose for the Allied. The fun part is, on the PlayStation, there were two discs. You can switch between them to do the other missions.
Yeah. The first thing you will notice when you play this game is that the analog sticks aren't working.
If you have a controller, a DualShock controller, you can't use the analog sticks.
Yeah, it sucked because there were a lot of games that would make good use of these sticks, but...
Yeah, and it's a shame that this game doesn't, because it was originally developed for PC and you would control with a mouse.
Yeah.
And now you had to use the directional pad. D-pad, and you have much more freedom by using an analog stick than by using the D-pad.
Yeah.
But this game came out in the early years of the PlayStation, so they probably didn't build in these controls for this stick. Also, one thing that really annoyed me was that you had to use passwords instead of saving.
Yeah.
Well, this was at the time that Nintendo included in almost every game cartridge their save battery, so you could save your game on the cartridge. But PlayStation also had their own thing for it was the memory card on which you could save your games. Red Alert didn't use that. They used long passwords which you had to type in every time if you wanted to restart a new level.
There were a couple of games that used this system, and Jurassic Park did it too, but you could save it on the memory card, but you could also use the passwords.
Look, if that's an option because you don't have a memory card, cool, fine by me,
but the PlayStation includes a memory card and they're pretty cheap, so why not? Yeah, pretty weird.
So yeah, like in every other RTS game, it's all about building your base. So you have different kind of buildings, like barracks to make your soldiers.
Yeah, and of course you got these factories which produce tanks, jeeps, that kind of stuff. But to make those troops or vehicles, you got some money.
Yeah, and you've got the harvesters to do so. So by building your main base, you also get one harvester. This harvester can travel to certain points on the map to collect the currency, which he has to deliver to your main base, and then you can use it to build other buildings and other troops. So yeah, there are these missions where you have to build your entire base and the enemy is doing that at the same time, and you have to attack each other. But there are also missions where you only have a small group with only two tanks and a few soldiers and a hero like Tanya, which is like a super soldier. So she has more life, does more damage, can shoot tanks in a few bullets. And you have to try and survive that entire level with those characters.
So the heroes are pretty cool. Mm-hmm. You got a super soldier. But the problem with this is that if she dies, the mission failed.
Yeah, and you have to restart the entire mission again. So maybe you are at the last part, like the last 2 minutes of this game. You've already did an hour over this level, you have to restart the entire mission. And basically, when I was playing this game again, this was the part where I fell over, because
yeah,
I had to restart like 6 or 7 times one level, and it really got annoying at a certain point.
Yeah, well, you got this better soldier, this super human, and you want to play with that character. You feel like you should play with that character to do some stuff in that level, and you are always scared that he or she dies in the level. And yeah,
what happens then is that you put it away to the back.
Yeah,
so you gotta protect.
You gotta play it safe.
Yeah, you gotta play it safe. But by playing it safe, most of the times it means that you are too weak to handle all the enemies. So yeah, you really have to manage between protecting her and also using her.
Yeah,
it's kind of hard.
Yeah, play it like a class kind of.
Yeah. Okay, so back to base building. The base building is kind of hard to become really good in, or to get
used to.
To get used to, indeed, because yeah, there are a lot of buttons you have to press to switch to the menu. So triangle is back to menu. In the menu, you can select certain kind of thing, certain kinds of objects. But sometimes when you press X, you go into the menu. There's another sub menu, and sometimes there isn't, and it starts to build directly.
Oh, right.
You would expect to, when you want to go out of this menu, you press circle.
Yeah.
But what it does is cancel the build that you're building at that moment. You can restart it by pressing X again.
Yeah, but
but if you press circle again, it will destroy it.
Yeah, we'll cancel it and destroy your building. Yeah. So, well, you get some resources back, but you won't get all of it.
Yeah.
Which sucks.
Which sucks, yeah. Yeah, also, it is an older game, so the gameplay is a little slow. You notice it that if you play an RTS by now, like StarCraft 2, or they are a lot faster to control. The levels are long, but it isn't because they are big levels. No, it's just because the game is a little bit slow.
Yeah, especially with the how you build and stuff. Let's say StarCraft, you all got these keen bindings, S and another S, and you build a spawning pool, or a P and an S. So you build a spawning pool, and here you got into the menu, you gotta do that, you gotta do that, and it takes a lot of time, which takes the pace out of the game.
I was surprised though that Red Alert does have a system for sorting out your soldiers. So you can make, you can select a few soldiers, give them a certain kind of group, so you can switch between those groups quickly. So you can make a group with only tanks and a group with only medics or something like that.
Cool.
And you can switch between them and only control them. So I was surprised that they included that already in this version.
Yeah, doesn't work as good in the new as in the newer games, of course.
No, of course not. Because it doesn't work that well, you don't use it often.
Cool.
Also fun to know is that this game is now considered as freeware on PC. So you can download this game for free on PC and play the entire game. Yeah.
But if you're a game collector, you'll find the PlayStation 1 game a lot more.
Yeah.
It's a lot more common than the PC games.
It's relatively cheap also, because I've bought it for €3 or something.
Yeah, so it has expansions.
And with the expansions come more campaign levels, but also more multiplayer levels.
Right.
So it's if you like the game, I would recommend buying this this expansion as well.
And are they included in the PC version?
Oh yeah, and don't forget, Command & Conquer Red Alert on the PlayStation 1, the base game, doesn't have a multiplayer function. So if you want to play together, you have to have this expansion.
Yeah, right.
Okay, so conclusion. Is Command & Conquer Red Alert still worth playing today? If you really enjoy these games and have a kind of nostalgia for this game, I think you will like to play it again. But by now, the RTS genre has evolved, has become way, way better than it was back then.
Mm-hmm.
I think you should play a newer game instead of Red Alert.
Yeah, I think you're better off too with a newer game. But I like RTS games. I like the genre. So I played a lot of Blizzard RTS for especially. And I didn't play Command & Conquer too much. I played it sometimes, but it isn't my type of game.
Yeah.
I was younger back then, of course. I can't see reason why you would play Command & Conquer right now. Well, of course, if you... Because there are still Command & Conquer games, right?
Yeah, there are still newer games, yeah.
Yeah, so if you're really a huge fan of that and maybe want to follow the story, or I have no clue why, but yeah, you should play it.
And I would recommend buying it on playing it on PC, because on PC the controls work way better because you've got the mouse and keyboard.
Yeah.
It's easier to manage your soldiers, your troops. So yeah, I would
stick and it's free.
And it's free, so I would stick to that version.
Yeah. So if you're a huge fan of Command & Conquer games, definitely you should buy it or play it.
Yeah.
But if you're just an RTS fan in general and you're into the newer games, there's no reason to really get back to the older games at all.
No. Okay guys, so we would like to know what you guys think about Command & Conquer Red Alert. Leave it down below. And we hope to see you next time on Away From Keyboard.
Later, guys.